So this is what I've been working on. I just finished working on this guy here. So there's six of these guys up in the air over the desert. The desert and sky, that's from a photograph I took out in Anza-Borrego. So I'm gonna start working on the insides of these. And here's my crazy palette I got going, which I've been keeping fresh with my Kirkland stretch tight plastic food wrap. There goes another 1/10 of 1% of 1 cent into my Instagram account, which I don't have. And here's my studio assistant, Tobin. He is very busy over here thinking about art. That's his main function. He just lays there and thinks about art. So, without further ado, that fresh beat is right on time. So I already painted the upper two sections on the inside and the front face. Front face is really kind of a wash. I'll probably go back over that later with something. Let's see. Keep on floating with my memories. Hell is empty, about to freeze. Well, that's sad. Keep dancing with my sanity. So I just, when I did the last one of these little guys, I tried to do it live on Instagram, but Instagram got mad because I was playing music in the background, and it was like, fuck you, we're gonna turn off your fucking video. So that didn't happen. And so I was sitting here painting and talking for about a half hour, and the video was off. That's pretty funny. That's another song that makes me want to dance. When I painted the sky and the desert, I don't have a easel big enough to hold both of these canvases at the same time, but I did have them vertical on a table where I just showed you where you first saw these things sitting up. But when I'm doing this painting, and I never done this like this before, but I just move the canvas around so much so that the point of my brush is always pointing towards the line I want to create. Anyway. There we go. Apologizing for using so many paper towels, but that's the way I was taught in college. Which of course is no excuse. I can easily change my behavior, but I choose to keep using paper towels because they make it so easy to keep things going. Which is kind of silly, but I don't know what else to say about that. this week, there's a couple of things happened this week. Of course, today is Saturday. I hope you guys are having a good weekend. But this week, we got a new electric grill. I've always used a propane grill in the past, so it was like a new experience. It was pretty fun. Got from the local Hillcrest Ace Hardware. And the first thing I grilled was some shrimp and some lobster that I got at Whole Foods. There's another shout out that I won't get any money for, but that's okay. And you know, I grew up in Texas. I did not grow up eating fish except for fried catfish. That was, well, I guess fish sticks. I don't know what the hell fish sticks were back in the 70s, but whatever fish that was. But I got some prawns and it came out kind of, I thought they were kind of chewy. Bunny was nice and said they were great. So if anybody knows the secret for not having chewy shrimp come off the grill, let me know.
I'm just going to say it.
There we go. That's kind of fun. I'm liking that. There we go. You know, I mixed this color by accident a while ago. I was trying to mix something else back when I thought I was live streaming on Instagram, and was so I was kind of embarrassed but kept going, and if I had any sense I would have looked at the damn camera. Anyway, so I was mixing this color for the floor, and it had way too much blue in it, and I didn't know what the hell I was going to do with it, but I'm really liking it on their little robes, so that's cool. You just never can tell how things are going to go as you sit down at, well, most people stand to paint. I know if my professor from college saw me sitting down painting, I'd probably get in very big trouble. Because real painters stand, by God. You're going to be a painter, get off your ass and stand there and paint. It's work, gosh darn it. Okay. Might want to ease up on the caffeine in the morning, professor. Just saying. You're a little scary. I don't think he was really like that. I think that's just a voice in my head.
I was going to say.
Did I mention therapy? Well, somebody should mention therapy often. How many people do you run into through the course of the day, and your first question is, how much therapy are you getting every week, and have you thought about getting more? Especially in the vegetable section of the supermarket, you can get into some pretty good arguments about vegetables at the supermarket. That's what I have noticed. Maybe I made that up. Maybe it wasn't vegetables. Maybe they were arguing about a parking spot. Okay, can I just mention, I live next to a Ralph's, and there's underground parking, which is really nice, because it's been hot, and it's nice to park in the shade, except their stupid escalator has been broke since before COVID. What the helicopter, Ralph's? Fix your damn escalator. And you know what? I just figured it was just this Ralph's here in Hillcrest, but then I go to Pacific Beach. They have the same setup, underground parking, with a little escalator that the carts work on, and it's out of commission too. I'm starting to see a conspiracy here, ladies and gentlemen. There is a conspiracy not to have escalators working at the Ralph's. Sorry about that. Anyway, did I mention therapy? I think I should have mentioned therapy by now. This guy's coming out kind of okay. Man, I love this song. And I've been listening to this band since like 2000, and I just found this song. You know why? Because I... Okay, I'll tell you why. Because I got most of my songs of this band off Napster before they got shut down the first time. So they weren't even, you know, they were just somebody's dumbass conversion to an MP3. And I didn't actually have any of their albums, which is really stupid if you want to support artists. And my excuse was, well, I bought all these albums. At the time, I had like over 200 albums. And I can't listen to them on my computer, so I'll use Napster to kind of catch up. That was my excuse, which is lame bullshit. But that was the story I was telling myself. Anyway, did I mention therapy a couple times? Did not go to therapy this week. Just mainly painted. Person has on a blindfold. I don't know why. This was the only one that had a blindfold, but anyway. Okay, there. So I kind of got a little start on these people. We could give them a little skin. If I didn't have so damn much blue in there. White. I need to try a little of this. That's a little better. There we go. That'll be a start. This person doesn't even really have a face for some reason. There's a really deep-seated reason. Okay. Now. So, what was... Oh, yeah. Got a new electric grill. That's what I was talking about. I got a little sidetracked. New electric grill. And, so we started out with those... Oh, yeah. Did I show you my Yeti? It's pretty cool. And there's Coke Zero in there. Two more... Shameless shout outs for people that aren't going to give me any money. But I'm not doing this for money. I'm doing this because I'm an artist and artists have to paint. And that's just the fucking deal. So there, bam, paint. Okay, I'm painting. Maybe talking a little too much, but painting and talking. After the shrimp, the next thing I barbecued was steak. Because the next day I went back to Whole Foods and I walked right by the fish department. Thank you, done with the fish. Uh-oh, damn it, I messed up. Now I have to get my eraser brush. This is my eraser brush, short bristles. I wish it was stiffer. It makes it easier to do what I'm gonna do. I went over the line a little bit right there, very annoying. So, get this wet and get the excess water out, and then come up with the bristles up to the line, going back and forth, and clean that off, clean it out and do it again. Now the brush is working like a sponge, and now I got rid of all that little mess I made. That's my erase brush. Okay, so, back to the meat department at Whole Foods, and they had this bomb ass fucking boneless ribeye. Oh my god, that shit was good. So I bought like $500 or $600 worth of that shit. Took that home and barbecued that with asparagus. They had asparagus. Yum, love to barbecue asparagus. And okay, now with the asparagus, just a little bit of olive oil. We're out of olive oil. I don't know who bought the avocado oil, but we have a bottle of that, and that apparently worked fine. So, avocado oil. We'll do it a pinch, and salt and pepper. That's the only thing I do to the vegetables on the grill. And then the only thing I did to the meat was just salt and pepper. I know I read somewhere you should let it sit out at room temperature for about 20 minutes or 30 minutes so it would get closer to, I don't know why. Anyway, so I just take them out of the fridge when I start the grill, and then I prepare the vegetables. And then by that time, I take the vegetables and the steak downstairs to the grill, and the grill's usually hot. And cooked up those, man, it was so good. And it made me realize the difference in buying really good cuts of meat and instead of just those wacky cuts of meat at Ralph's. Oh my God, don't let me get started on Ralph's meat. And I'm sure there might be some good Ralph's meat people out there. I apologize if that seemed like meatist. Is that a word? Meatist? Probably elitist would be a better word. I have to get all my steaks from Whole Foods, which is bought by Amazon now, which caused this guy to start singing in Polish. This guy's singing in Polish about how stupid it is that Amazon bought Whole Foods. Mr. Jeff Bezos, who has so much money, it's like he could spend $1 billion a minute for the rest of his life and he would never run out of money. I mean, there's not even enough things to buy it. Well, I guess he could go on Amazon and hit the one of everything button. That might be $1 billion. Hit the one of everything button on Amazon. Do they have a one of everything button? They ought to have one of those. That's what I'm saying. Poranny świt będzie nam śpiewać, da mi synów I córki. We heard this song right here in, I don't remember the name of the show, but it was a Polish police drama on Netflix. I think it was Netflix. Hopefully it wasn't Slamazon Prime, but it could have been. Anyway, oh yeah, back to the steak. So I bought way too much steak. There's no way we ate that much steak at one sitting. So I had this leftover steak. So the rest of the week, oh my God, prime rib quesadillas. It was so good. Love quesadillas. Now, in general, if you try to put chicken into my quesadilla, I'll get really mad because it's usually that taco shop chicken that's really moist and actually wet. And it, man, there's nothing worse than wet melted cheese. That's just disgusting. Don't ever put chicken in my quesadilla. But you can chop up really expensive ribeye and throw it in there anytime because that shit was a bomb. Oh my God, it was good. Bunny even had a couple and she really liked them. And of course, I got tortillas from Pancho Villa's on El Cajon Boulevard, just east of Interstate 805, where they make handmade tortillas every single day. Oh my God, those things are good. Talk about the bomb. Well, I've only got two left, so I need to go back and get more. Just saying. All right, so we got this little guy painted in. Gonna start on this little guy over here with the same color. So that was my story about the new grill. Yay steaks and shrimp. I'll have to work on the shrimp. I'm just not a fish guy. I love living in San Diego, but there's always going to be a part of my heart in Texas. And there's just no shrimp in where I grew up. Oopsie. No shrimp at all. Yeah, I grew up, like I said, with Swanson TV dinners and pot pies. And, oh my God, hominy. Hominy with leftovers on Friday night is like the worst thing ever. Almost as bad as soggy fish sticks when there's no more tartar sauce. And then you try to put ketchup on them, and man, ketchup on fish sticks, that just is not right. It doesn't work. Not very yummy at all. Okay. So when I finish these two inside walls, I just got the back wall and the floor to do. And all my friends make fun of me that there's actually people in this world that call me Mr. Weatherly. They think that's just stupid. Nobody should call me Mr. Weatherly. But whatever, there it is. And school starts up in a couple of weeks. I'm going to go in next week and get ahead of the curve. Because, of course, the way my crazy life works out, the only dates I can rent the Airbnb next door to our house while we get the house tinted is the first day I go back with all the staff before we have students, so that's really stupid. Let's just have like 9 stressful things happen all on the same day. How about that? Okay, whatever. What's next? So that's what's gonna happen. Never had the house tinted before. I think we should have had it tinted about 20 years ago, but here we are, finally getting it tinted. Got the little checklist of all the things to do before they show up, which I'll probably look at the night before. No, I'll look up before then. Another little mistake. Yeah. This is also from that Polish police show. Where is that? I just love music. I constantly find new music. And I love music where I don't know what the words mean. Like, I just love this beat and I love the energy in it. I have no idea what they're singing about, but it sounds good to me. Okay, now. Let's paint that floor next. How about that? How about that, John? How about you paint that damn floor next? Maybe you could talk a little less and paint a little more. I don't really think that's necessary to have that kind of aggression. Did I mention therapy? You know what I like about therapy? I like when I walk out of a therapy session and get in my car and feel like everything's gonna be okay. I do like that. I do like that part. Yeah. I don't like the crying so much. I had definitely cried in therapy. That's for sure. I've cried in class before, which is kind of embarrassing. It feels a little out of control. However, you know, oopsie, now I made a mistake. I'm not a teacher that tries to act like adults are perfect. But I am not perfect. I've had to apologize in class before. Because because it is no fun sitting on stupid stuff I did when an apology is called for. So I tend to apologize right away. Because sometimes I say dumb stuff, or I do dumb stuff, or sometimes I forget things. And, you know, kids got enough crap going on in their lives. They don't need some crazy old guy who's still mad that Reagan got elected president. That's not true. When Reagan was elected, I could care less. I didn't follow politics till I was like 30. Anyway, they don't need some crazy old guy bugging them. They need people to support them through a very stressful time in their life. And it helps if you have enthusiasm about what you do. Like, apparently I like art a lot, or I wouldn't be filming this crap and saying all this dumb shit. But I do like art a lot, and I like young kids a lot. Because kids will think up stuff I've never thought of, which is really fun. I know some teachers can end up teaching the exact same ideas and lectures, you know, for 30 years straight. And I try not to do that. I try to be open to new ideas. And because kids definitely have a lot of new ideas if you listen to them. Of course, some of them don't say much. They definitely don't say much first period. My first period class last year, oh my God, they would not talk to me. They would talk to me one-on-one, but when I was talking to the whole class and I would ask a question, like, how's everybody doing today? They would just stare at me like I was speaking in a language they did not understand, and they could care less what I said, and they were not gonna engage. And then I would stop trying to do that dumb shit and walk around the room, and like one-on-one or little groups of two or three kids, they would talk. That's first period. By sixth period, they won't shut up. By the end of the day, they have finally woken up. They are so full of energy from all the sugar and caffeine they had at lunch. And they just want to get out of there, and they have so many important things to say out loud to everyone in range for like 10 miles. And then this happened, blah, 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 blah. And by that time of the day, I have like zero excess energy. Like right now, I'm pretty energetic, but what time is it right now? It's like 9:30 in the morning. I'm still pretty energetic. I'm still working on my Coke Zero. But by sixth period, the end of the day, when sixth period gets out at like almost 3:30, I am out of excess energy. I'm just exhausted. And it's a struggle to stay present in the room. It's a struggle to give the last group of kids the same things I can give the first group of kids. But I try to do the best I can, and I try not to beat myself up for being human. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, I'm looking forward to going back to school. Looking forward to a new group of kids. I'm looking forward to a year with a lot more juniors than I've had in the past, so I can have a lot more second year kids next year. Because what I like to teach really is a 2-year sequence. Because by March the first year, we start school in August. By March, kids are really starting to embrace the things they've learned and to come up with their own ideas of things they want to try to make. Or they've had enough of ceramics and they want to get out. That can also happen in October. There's just some people by October, they're like, what do you mean we're going to work with clay again? Yeah, we're pretty much going to do that every single day all year. Oh my gosh, that's why it's called ceramics. But the people that get into it and they start to have their own ideas, they really start to enjoy making things on their own, then the whole second year, they can make whatever they want as long as they keep coming up with ideas. If they don't, I help them come up with ideas. And it's just so fun to watch a second year kid make this journey into what they can accomplish with clay. And so I'm supposed to start out this year with at least 20 juniors who want to be there, because I interviewed them last year, not just getting thrown in there to fill up a seat, so that next year I'll have 20 second years that really want to be there, instead of second years that got thrown into a seat for the second year in a row and didn't really like it the first year and definitely did not want to work with clay the second year. That can happen sometimes. Some of those people are really helpful. They can really be helpful in the studio and help with stuff. Like they don't really want to make anything anymore, but they like to learn how to load the kiln. They like to learn how to make new glazes, stuff like that. That's really helpful. I've had some great kids like that for a second year who were able to help out with things that needed to get accomplished in the studio. That was fun. So I worked out this value, because you've got to get values that work to create the three-dimensional space you're trying to create the illusion of on a two-dimensional surface. So these two are really light, and then this one is probably next lightest, and then this one, and then this is the darkest one. So I worked these out on the palette before I ever started painting them, kind of looking at them. I did have to make some adjustments. Once you start putting these down on the canvas, there may be like this color may be too close to this one, or this one could be too close to this one. Because you definitely want you want separation of space, separation of perspective. You don't want to in some cases, you may want to make the viewer work to understand what's going on, but as far as these little huts are concerned, I want them to pop off the canvas where their form is very obvious to the viewer. The light source is ambiguous, and so is the perspective is ambiguous. Because you could not have these things set up like this in a straight line and see the same perspective in each one, which is what I did. So there's six vanishing points instead of one vanishing point. The only way you could do that is if they were in an arc. I may have said that before. I don't really know what's going on with the top of that guy, but there it is. Now let's get the other edge. And then it might be time after this little guy to go do something inside. I've been playing Fallout 4. I love playing Fallout 4 and making settlements and then building places for them to live and work. God, it's so fun. I don't know why. I love doing that over and over again. It's kind of like a distraction. I'm also convinced if someone could really work out a way to take a lot of boring education and put it into a video game where kids have to go on quests to learn new things, that education would take off in another direction. Unfortunately, what that doesn't do, at least in my mind, I guess there might be a way to do it, but there's just things that happen in the classroom, being right in the room with somebody, that I don't think could ever really happen trying to learn something on a computer. There are definitely some cultures that can connect much quicker and easier learning something one-on-one with a computer, which I can relate to that. I've done things like that in my adult life. That did not exist when I was in high school. I guess there were computers in existence. Well, yeah, there were definitely computers, but there were no computers in my school. The closest thing to my high school, like a computer, was a typewriter. I did take typing. I think it was my sophomore year I took typing. I don't know why. That was, and the typing teacher was really not happy that I was there. She didn't like me very much. I don't blame her. It's really hard for me to sit still. And it definitely was. I mean, typing's kind of boring after a while. And I had that crap for a whole year. Can you imagine that? That is just crazy. Alrighty. So I'm getting close to finishing. This is the last area of color. Some of this I'll have to go over a second time, but I'm not gonna do that on this video. After I finish this, I'll say goodbye and go do some editing. And see about getting this thing posted. I don't know why, I just wanted to, well, for one thing, school's about to start, and this is a way for me to kind of get back in the swing of talking to people, even though nobody else is, well, Tobin's over there sleeping, my studio assistant, but there's no people in here, it's just me. But I'm imagining somebody someday might actually watch this on my Instagram, and I'm talking to you about what I'm doing on the canvas and what I'm doing this week. It has been a fun week. I love painting. Man, I came in here the other morning. Like, I wake up, I come upstairs, and my mind is like, dude, you gotta go look at the painting. And it just reminds me of back in the 90s when I was painting all the time. I mean, paintings would wake me up because they were right in my bedroom, because I just had one room, and I would wake up and there was the painting would be like waiting, like, dude, what are you doing sleeping? Get out of bed and paint, you dumbass. Anyway, okay, so that's enough of this. Move that out. But this is a nice start with this little guy. Okay, so I'll put this back up here where it goes. Let's see if I can get this off. So this is the one from yesterday, and then here's the one I was working on just now. Like, if I come across the room, kind of see how they're coming to life. And then here's the other ones I did. There's that guy, and that guy, and that guy that Rob wants to buy. And then there's that guy, and that one, and that one. And Tobin, do you have anything you want to add to the viewing audience? Do you have anything you want to tell them? Not really? Okay, buddy. Sorry about that. Well, I hope you're having a good day. Bye.